Hello everybody, welcome to your next part of your training. Today we're going to talk about what is solder. All right, solder is a metal or metallic alloy used to join metallic surfaces when melted. There are generally two types of solder, a tin lead mixture and a lead free base mixture. Actually not a mixture. Tin lead is a mixture of tin and lead, usually a 60-40 split. The most common ones that you'll see is a 63-37 split, which is actually a little bit easier to work with. Reason why is on a 60-40 split, you have a melting point of about 180 to 190 degrees Celsius. With the 63-37, it drops a little bit. A lead-free base solder is essentially without lead. Its general melting point of lead-free is 22-45 degrees Celsius higher than your normal tin lead mixture. Problem with a higher temperature is it can give you shorter tip life due to oxidation and corrosion, because essentially heat creates oxidation on your tip. So this is actually not good for what you would be doing. So we would recommend the tin lead mixture. Using lead free will reduce your tip life up to 4 to 5 times compared to using a tin lead mixture based solder, okay? In our next part here, we're gonna talk about kind of what it looks like on your solder wire. It is very flexible. It's just a wire of solder. There are two types of solder. There's solder paste, and then there's solder wire. The solder paste is much like the solder wire, but it's not in a solid form, it's in a paste form. So depending on the application that you're using, you would want to use either solder paste or solder wire. The downfall to solder paste is if you're not using it frequently, there is a shelf life on solder paste. I believe it's around 6 months. Don't quote me on that, but I believe it's around 6 months. So if you're not consistently using that paste within that 6 month time frame, you could possibly just be costing yourself money. If you're going to be using the solder wire, which has no shelf life, on the front of the solder wire, you'll see the description here. This one's actually a 63-37. Some solder wires have a flux core. Flux is used to help prevent oxidation, so it's actually a little bit easier to work with as well too. There's different diameters of solder wire that you can purchase. This diameter is a 0.45 millimeters. So this one's actually pretty good to work with what we do. You can get them a little bit smaller, but generally the 0.45 is a good range. If you guys have any questions, go ahead and write your comments below and we'll make sure we get those answered for you. We'll see you in the next part of the training.